குருகணேஷாபியாம் நமஹ. இன் அன் ஏர்லியர் எபிசோட் ஹைலைட்டிங் ஹவு கரெக்ட் ப்ரனன்சியேஷன் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஃபார் எனி மந்த்ரா டு ஒர்க், மந்த்ரா டு கிவ் இட்ஸ் டிசைட் எஃபெக்ட், வி ஹவ் டேக்கன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் தி வேர்ட் கிருஷ்ணா அண்ட் சீன் தேட் தேர் ஆர் பொசிஷன்ஸ் இன் த ஸ்பீச் ஆர்கன் ஆர் ஸ்பீச் system for each and every alphabet or syllable. Shakara's position is Murdha or upper head. Sakara's position is teeth. Sha is in upper head and Sa is in teeth. When you pronounce Shakara, the vibrations are at the upper part of your head, inside. Whereas Sakara is pronounced with the help of the teeth. When you pronounce Sakara, you will see your tongue touching the teeth. So, instead of Krishna, if you say Krishna, then the flow of sound, Kr is produced at the throat. When it is pronounced correctly as Krishna, the sound flows from the throat towards upper head. And when you pronounce it as Krishna, the flow is deflected towards the teeth. The effect may be completely different. This we had seen earlier. Let's now look at another aspect. This was about the flow of sound. A different aspect now. Every alphabet in Sanskrit has a character of its own, a nature of its own. Sanskrit alphabets are called aksharas. Kshara means end, vinasha, destruction. Alphabets of Sanskrit are akshara because they never end. They never get destroyed. Even at pralaya, even after pralaya, they are still there. They don't die. This is why they are called aksharas, without kshara. This is peculiar about Sanskrit. This may not be the case with other languages. Sanskrit means most of the Indian languages which use the same set of alphabets. The swaras such as a, a, e, e, and vyanjanas such as kavarga, chavarga. So this applies to most of them, most of the Indian languages. After pralaya, when the creation happens, they simply reappear as they were before pralaya. Aksharas of Sanskrit are nitya, shashvata. Nobody has created them. They have not evolved out of something. They have not evolved out of interactions, human interactions. If you see, most languages are evolving as people go on speaking. Generation after generation, languages evolve. The way English was spoken 2 centuries back, even in England, that's not how it is spoken now. Words have disappeared. Are you aware that at one point of time, ampersand, the and symbol, was considered the 27th alphabet in English? Which is no longer the case. There was a long S and a short S in English at one point of time. These changes happen in languages that have evolved out of human interaction. But that is not the case with Sanskrit. The programming languages, even though they use the English alphabets and special characters, their purpose and effects are completely different. You won't be able to use them for regular one-to-one communication. Programming languages are man-made languages within a short span of time. Languages such as English have evolved over thousands of years. What I mean to say is that when Brahma created the world out of Shabda Brahma, English alphabets were not present. Sanskrit alphabets were still there. Brahma didn't create Sanskrit alphabets. At the time Brahma came into existence, Sanskrit alphabets were already there. In the form of sound, not necessarily the script. Alphabet has got 2 aspects, sound and script. So I am talking about the sound, not script. So our sages through meditation have tried to understand the nature of each Sanskrit alphabet. What they represent, what they contain, what effect they can produce. So when you utter a certain word in Sanskrit, it is the combined effect of all the alphabets or syllables in it that would manifest. We will see this by comparing Shakara and Sakara as in Krishna and Krishna. Shakara first. Shakaram Shrunu Charvangi Ashtakonamayam Sada Rektachandra Pratikasham Swayam Paramakundalim Chaturvargamayam Varnam Sudhanarmita Vigraham Panchadevamayam Varnam Panchapranamayam Sada Rajas Sattva Tamo Yuktam Trishakti Sahidam Sada Tribindu Sahidam Varnam Atmadi Tattva Sanyudam Sarvadevamayam Varnam Hridi Bhavaya Parvati. Mahadeva is telling this to Parvati Devi. Nature of Shakara. Shakara is octagonal. Doesn't mean that it is written as an octagon. If you manifest something by repeated chanting of Shakara, it will be octagonal in shape. Remember the shapes in yantras, Trikona, Shatkona, Ashtakona. Every yantra, every combination of geometries in a yantra will be unique to a particular devata. Like that, Shakara's two-dimensional manifestation is octagon. This is what the sages saw through meditation and realized. Shakara looks like a red moon. That is a color. Parama Kundali, Kula Kundalini Shakti. This has a definition of its own. We will not go into so much of detail. Shakara is Kundalini Shakti itself. Chaturvargamayam Varnam. Chaturvarga means the four Purusharthas, Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. All these four, Shakara is present in them. Or they are present in Shakara. Shakara is capable of giving all these four. Shakara is made of Sudha, Amrita. Its material is Amrita. Panchadevamayam Varnam. The five Devatas who are worshipped in Panchayatana Puja. Ganesha, Shiva, Vishnu, Devi and Surya, their presence is there in Shakara. All the three gunas, Sattva, Rajas, Tamo gunas, they are present in Shakara. All the three Shaktis, Ichha Shakti, Jnana Shakti and Kriya Shakti, they are there in Shakara. Tribindu or Bindutraya, it is a concept of Trinity in Shakta system. There are many interpretations. Since we are talking about Aksharas here, one way to look at the concept of Bindutraya will be Swaras and Vyanjanas separately as two sets and the third they together as their combinations. Atmadi Tattva Sanyutam. Shakara has tattvas in it starting from Atma, such as Atma. All devatas reside in Shakara. Sarvadevamayam Varnam, Shakara. Now, Sakara. Shuklambaram Shuklavarnam Dvibhujam Raktalochanam Shweta Chandana Liptangi Muktaharopa Shobhitam Gandharvagiyamanancha Sadanandamayim Param Ashtasiddhipradam Nityam Bhaktananda Vivardhinim Evam Dhyatva Sakarantu Tan Mantram Dashadha Japeta Trishakti Sahitam Varnam Atmadi Tattva Sanyutam Pranamya Satatan Devi Hridi Bhavaya Sundari. Sakara is white color. White in color, wearing white clothes, two hands, red eyes, anointed with white sandal. The regular sandal paste is applied on her body. The alphabet is being described as a female. She is wearing a garland of pearls. She is the favorite alphabet of Gandharvas. They use this alphabet a lot. If you want, you can connect this to music, Saregama. Gandharvas are the singers. She is always pleasant and happy. She can give Ashta Siddhis. She is connected to devotion, bhakti. She increases the ananda of the bhakta. Sakara also has the three shaktis and contains tattvas starting from Atma. Are they the same? Just for comparison, Kundalini Shakti is missing in Sakara. Rather than the intense Kundalini Shakti, it is the ananda of bhakti that is present in Sakara. Purusharthas, achievement of Purusharthas are missing in Sakara. Representation of Bindutraya is missing in Sakara. These are all present only in Shakara. I am not saying that Sakara is inferior compared to Shakara. Its nature itself is different. What Sakara can give, they are different. This is why pronunciation as Krishna and Krishna, they are not the same. Their effects are not the same. Let's not oversimplify everything in the name of Vedanta or Bhakti. If you want to do that, then you should be mature enough to accept good and bad alike, Sukha and Dukha alike, pleasure and pain alike. If you are at that level, Shakara and Sakara will not matter much. Until then, each one has its own specific effect and result. Harihi Om.
Yajna Nishre Hatamal Karma.